show or something.
Are we sponsored by Dasani or something? No, there was Isomet. Maybe.
What was in it? Just water?
Yeah, Celsius. Yeah, so it's not clumpy. They mix in hot water and then put Isomet in the water. That's, I hate when like it's chunky.
Can I ask one?
Yeah, go ahead.
Is it possible he could like move right there?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
I'm so sorry.
No, I didn't realize it was your shot. You're good.
I thought he was about to ask you to move.
First of all, everyone, thank you for coming. We're excited to be here today, a day of celebration, celebrating the first national championship in Division II history. With that, I'll turn it over to head coach Daniel Owenby to say a few words, and then Gabe, open it up, and then after that, we'll get some questions.
I just want to thank everyone for coming. Definitely a historic moment, not only for our program, but for the university, and we're extremely honored to be here. I just want to give a quick shout out to Dr. Stewart, Mark Richards, just for giving me the opportunity to be able to build this program up and giving us the opportunity to have wrestling here in the state of Alabama. I'm so grateful to be here and to be in this situation, and so grateful to have Gabe on our program and for him to have done the things he's done this year.
Yeah. Once again, thanks for being here. This has been really cool. I'm honored to, you know, hold this this stature of being the first national champ for the school. And, you know, I can't thank this guy and also my other assistant, Michael, for, you know, bringing me here and believing in me. And, you know, this has been a really special moment for me, and the support I get from the school and just all the people around, it's been awesome. So, thanks.
All right, so we'll take some questions.
On the ABC, so what's the importance of you winning this championship?
You know, it was it's something that I've worked for a long time, and this is why I came to Montevallo. You know, my club that I help coach at during the season and out of season is like 10 minutes down the road, and, you know, I live 5 minutes down the road, and I know people in Alabama have been waiting for, you know, something like this, like for a college wrestling school for a while. So, you know, that was my goal coming in, is to show the support for the guys in Alabama, you know.
What does it mean for you to be the first, not just for the program, but for Montevallo as well, as the national champion?
It means a lot. You know, it holds a special place in my heart. I love this place since the first day I stepped on campus. And like I said, I'm honored to do that. And, you know, I hope more follow my footsteps. So do what I do and do more. You know, that's my goal.
Go ahead, Jake.
Gabe, I remember talking with you guys when wrestling became a thing, and talking with a lot of you guys said you want to make history. When did it hit you, just the magnitude of what you accomplished individually for yourself?
You know, I was telling Coach this, like, right before my match, I was the second weight class to go, and the guy who won the 125-pound weight class, he came running back to behind the stage, and, you know, there was like 40 people back there celebrating him, giving him high fives and stuff, and I was like, oh, crap, I'm up. Like, this is my time. And, like, I ran out there, and then, like, the announcer, like, he's, like, first one in school history and, like, going through all the firsts. And I'm like, all right, I got to finish the job. This is important. And then, you know, once I won, that was, like, the first time I've ever celebrated in a match. I've never been that kind of guy. But just the emotion behind it, it was really important to me, so.
What was the reception like when he came back?
It was unbelievable. I think before, like, within, like, 30 minutes, my phone was, like, I was already down to, like, 15%. I think it was on 100 before. It was crazy. everyone in the arena was like telling me good job, you know, people I knew, people I didn't know. So it was just it was awesome. Well, there's not much in Wichita, but when I got to the arena, I told Coach this. You know, I was super, super nervous. I reached out to one of my best friends, and I was like, because he's wrestling the NCAA tournament, and he's a two-time All-American, and I was just asking him for, you know, help with dealing with the nerves, and we talked for like a good 30 minutes, and he really helped me. So it was just like when I got there, it was a little bit overwhelming, but, you know, controlling my emotions and getting it all figured out and, you know, getting used to it was a little challenge, but.
So, Coach, how does it feel like to train someone and then they succeed with expectations like this?
It was awesome just to watching him come in day one from preseason and watching him do all the right things throughout the entire year. Watching him buy in. I mean, he came from a very successful program and has wrestled for some very successful coaches. But just knowing that he came in and bought into what Coach Land and I were saying, just kind of listening to the advice that we were giving him, being able to take criticism and to continue to want to learn. I don't think I could have asked for a better athlete, especially for a first-year program, especially because we are so young. We do have a lot of freshmen, and they look up to him, and he set the right example, and he set the example of what we want the standard to be here, set the bar high, and it's amazing to have coached someone that had the drive that he had, and have the dedication that he had, and I just hope that our guys can take after him, and we just go sky high from here.
You know, you're right. That was definitely the hardest match, probably the whole year. Not nerves wise, you know, I was obviously super confident going into it, but you know, he got the lead early in the match, and that wasn't something I experienced at all this year. So dealing with that adversity was a challenge. And you know, I knew that kid was tough. I've seen him wrestle throughout the year. He dropped a couple matches, but I knew that he was probably going to be the toughest kid I was going to wrestle all year. It wasn't a surprise that I was wrestling him in the semis, but yeah, it was just the whole time during the match, you know, I was believing in myself, and they were actually mic'd up, and I heard Michael say like 15 times, like, you got to believe in yourself, you got to believe in yourself, and that was what I kept doing. So it was just going in there with the belief, and that's what helped. So.
Just for tournament-wise, just making sure we took it one match at a time. The way the Division II is structured is you wrestle first day 1 at 10 a.m., the next one at 5, and you come in the next day, you wrestle your semifinals at 10 and your finals at 7. So just telling them you got to take it one match at a time. Don't worry about who you got coming up next. Don't worry about your weight at the moment. Don't worry about anything besides this next 7 minutes you got coming up. And he did a fantastic job of every single session coming in, getting the right type of warm-up in, getting the right type of just sprints at the very end to get his lungs in the right type of way. That way we can go out there and wrestle to the best of our capabilities, but just one match at a time. And just honing back in on the fact that he bought in, and he just bought into everything we were saying. Coach Land was in his ears, as Gabe said, just making sure he was staying confident, making sure he was staying focused and ready to go. And Michael definitely was a massive help and a massive reason why Gabe was able to stay focused. He was pretty much helping him train all the way up till nationals, and when we got to nationals was still getting on the mat with him, was helping him get to practice. I allowed Michael to run the warm-ups because I knew he was really comfortable with Gabe, and so it was definitely a huge benefit to have Coach Land there and in Gabe's ear and making sure he was staying confident as well.
At what point in the year did you
You know, that was my goal going into it. You know, I wanted to win every match. So I believed in it from the beginning. But like Coach has said, you got to take it one match at a time. And you know, if I were to have lost a match before Nationals, it was what it was. Luckily, it didn't happen. But, you know, the place I didn't want to lose a match was at Nationals. And so, you know, whatever happened before then, it was what it was. But, no, I'm grateful that, you know, I got to cap my season off as an undefeated season. So.
I know this season was also hard for you guys with the loss of a teammate. You guys had to back out of conferences because of it. How are you guys able to – how are you personally just able to power through all of that and just carry on his memory throughout this as well?
It was unfortunate that we did lose Barrett Dempsey throughout the year. We did have to cancel our match against Huntington. However, one thing that that Barrett had was a great attitude about him and a great love for this campus and this team. And so I think it was definitely a rallying point right there at the end of our season for our guys to continue to finish the season strong, especially in his honor, because I know that's what he wanted us to do. He wanted us to go out and especially for Gabe to finish business. One of the cooler things is we got to bring him on that long road trip with us, and that's when him and Gabe kind of got a little bit closer. We're stuck in 15-passenger vans from here to Indianapolis, from Indianapolis to Greenwood, and Greenwood all the way back to here. And so it was seeing his drive and his dedication, especially when it was his turn to be called. Unfortunately, we had some injuries at the Greyhound Open, and it was his turn to step in and be the starter for the duel against Emmanuel and the duel against King. And I mean, he was right there, ready to step up and ready to take the responsibility of being the starter. And he's going to be missed, but he won't be forgotten. He'll live on in our program for years and years to come. So one of our things that we've been saying all year long is why not us? Through the entire recruiting process of everyone I've recruited this year and last year, I've said I want to win now. I don't want to be one of those programs that takes a couple years to, quote, develop or makes the excuse of, oh, we're just freshmen or we're just a first-year program. I want to win now. And with Gabe coming in and winning a national title, it essentially shows that what I was saying wasn't all just smoke and mirrors. It's what we're going to do. We're going to win now. And so right now it's national champ year one, and the goal is to reload and be the first ever second year program to bring home a team trophy. For at least for wrestling, we're the first ever first year program to ever have a national champ. So we made history that way, and so we're just looking to continue to make history, and we're going to bring home a team trophy next year. It's definitely been a fun experience. Just getting to know every single one of these young men personally, bringing them in and trying to build the type of culture that we want here. Especially for the fact that we are the first ever Division II program in Alabama. Especially we're the first Division II in Alabama, Florida, Mississippi, Louisiana. So we've got a really good size pool to pull from. And so just giving these kids an opportunity to wrestle close to home was something that very highly intrigued me coming here, but also being able to start a program from the ground up and insert my culture right away, because it's a lot different than taking over a program and having to shift through some of the guys that you hadn't recruited. I got the great opportunity to recruit everybody on this team, and so I've enjoyed every single second of it, getting to know all these young men and seeing them grow, and I continue to long for the opportunity to still see them grow and see how far we can go with these individuals and continue to bring in the right type of student athletes, especially with the fact that with being student athletes, our guys have been academic weapons this year, and so that's what we try to harp, just making sure that we're bringing in the right type of individuals. So
and this question is for Gabe. So Gabe, we
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, if this was an option, graduating high school, I wouldn't have been surprised, you know, if I did stay home. I love my support here. It's huge. And, you know, I just, it can't be matched anywhere else. The guys that I've made bonds with, you know, through my club, through high school, and through now Montevallo, it's crazy. And, you know, this guy, like, he believed me so much. And the support he gave me throughout the season, and the just the family that we've grown here, you know, it's been awesome. And, you know, that's a big reason why I did transfer here, is because I knew, like, you know, the people that were wanting to see this and wanting, you know, wrestling to be in Alabama, there was a huge following for it. And, you know, you guys saw our first duel. I mean, the arena was packed. And that was awesome. That wasn't something I even experienced in my last school. So, so it was awesome for that. Oh yeah, yep. They were here for the parade thing, and yeah.
So now that you've set the bar so high, do you have any like words of wisdom for future wrestlers coming up in the program behind you? Advice?
My biggest advice is you got to believe. You can do this. A quote that I saw that was from a national champ who's a wrestler is, you know, to be great, simple, right? You got to work harder, do extra, do all the right things, but it's not easy. So being great, simple, but it's not easy. And, you know, that's what I tell them. Like, we know what to do. Like, we can give you the key to success, but you got to be able to do it. And just mind over matter and believe in yourself, believe in your coaches, your training, and just have to battle right there. So. I did. We went to Dave and Buster's. So.
I'm just going to point out, I did beat the national champ in Hungry Hungry Hippos, yeah. So there's that.
It's true, unfortunately. You know, obviously the plan moving forward is to do it again, and hopefully not by myself. Biggest takeaway is this family and the support. It's awesome. We're building something special here, but there's definitely room for improvement. You know, we don't, like, it's cool and all to do this, but, you know, I don't want to make that trip by myself again. It was fun, but would definitely love to have my teammates there, you know, seeing all these other teams, and they have 7-8 guys there, you know. That's what we want to do, and we want to be the team, you know, up there celebrating with the team trophy. So my takeaway is we got the guys to do it, but we just need them to buy in now and you know, put their heart and mind to it, and hopefully we get that done.
Big takeaway is just making sure that we're staying focused all year long. Again, we gotta do a really good job with this recruiting class coming up, and I think right now we're on the right track. But even outside of just the recruiting class, I think with the guys we have on the team, we have the individuals that we are able to do with. Just making sure that they're staying focused all off season, staying focused all summer, and coming in the fall. Now it's their turn to be quote big brothers. Everyone coming in this year was freshmen. It was a little bit of a challenge, but. Now that we're going to have some upperclassmen and some guys that have been through the program for 1 year, I'm just excited to watch them grow. So I think with the individuals we have now, we're able to do it. But obviously, with college athletics, you got to bring in a good recruiting class. And so we're going to bring in a good recruiting class. We're going to develop the guys we have. And I think next year, as I've said, as Gabe said, we're going to come away with the team trophy.
That was something I struggled with this year. You know, before Midwest, you know, people kind of knew who I was, but after Midwest, it was like I was ranked number one, and, you know, I felt like there was this big target on me, and, you know, people were just trying to hold matches close and trying to steal a match, and it was really aggravating to me because, you know, it felt like they weren't really trying to wrestle. They were just trying to have a close match. And, you know, I talked to some of my, you know, my old coaches about it. I was like, man, I just feel like I'm not, like, scoring as many points as I was at the beginning of the year. And he was like, dude, you're ranked number one in the country. They're not, like, they're not going to let you. And so I think just, you know, going into matches knowing that I'm going to have to do a little bit more, and I'm going to get everyone's best. You know, everyone wants to be the number one guy. But, you know, it's definitely for sure a little bit of a challenge. So that's something I got to keep in mind going into every match is, you know, they're just going to try and steal it from you. So, you know, just got to have the same belief.
Perfect. Thank you. No one has anything else? Thanks, guys. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you.